Hell is this anyway? Am I under arrest or what?
Oh, no, sir. Would you like to sit down, Mr. Conley? I just want to ask you a few questions.
You could ask me the questions of my house without dragging me down here with the neighbors looking on.
That was necessary.
I want my lawyer.
You won't need him. I'm not accusing you of anything.
That sergeant tells me that a gun was found in the empty lot next to my house. And you say you're not accusing me of something?
Is this more or less the statement that you made to Sergeant Brady concerning your activities on the night Mr. Chambers died?
This is it. Why, you want it notarized?
Sir, I'm not the one whose dinner's getting cold. If you'll just answer a couple of questions, you're free to go. Thank you very much. It says here you went to bed around 12:30.
That's right.
Did you sleep soundly, sir, or did you happen to wake up at any time during the night?
I slept like a log. I usually do.
Your bedroom faces that vacant lot. Is it possible that you noticed a car outside, say, around 2:30, 3 o'clock?
My eyes were closed. I was probably snoring. No, Lieutenant, I didn't notice.
You're sure about this?
Yes, I am sure.
Okay, Mr. Conley, you're free to go. Thank you very much.
That is it? You brought me all the way down here for that?
If I need anything else, I'll call you, sir.
Oh, you do that.
The officer outside will drive you home.
Thanks.
When you picked him up, the neighbors noticed?
Two squad cars, flashing lights. I did everything but throw the cuffs on them. Yeah, they noticed, Lieutenant. So what now?
The lady has dropped a trail of crumbs leading right to Mr. Conley's doorstep. The least I can do is oblige. But my gut tells me there's more to it, Mr. Brady. A lot more.
Just one more thing.